What are the other devastating effects of miracle-centered gospel? You know, my heart is bleeding. Because our leaders who are doing this, our leaders and our pastors, sincerely, I think they don't just see it from this angle. I think they're good men. I think most of them are not, maybe they don't intend it for evil. I think that most of them don't, they don't just see from what I'm saying. So that's why I must express myself. And that's why I must cry out aloud. And that's why I must knock on the doors, and I must let them know that I'm not against the church. I'm not against miracles. I am a miracle worker myself. I believe in miracles. My life is a miracle itself. If you go to see my book, Olorunwa, is called my autobiography book. Go get that book, my autobiography. You know that my life is full of miracles. I believe in the power of God. I believe that God is able to do everything and all things, but not the things that he has told you to do. God will not come and do what you are supposed to do for you. God is not a jobless person. God is not an irresponsible person to come and be taking your responsibility upon himself, to come and be doing for you what you are supposed to do for yourself. God is not going to come from his throne and be fixing your land that he has put you over to manage for him and to take responsibility for. God is not going to do for you what you are supposed to do for yourself. God is not going to fix your country where he has placed you to fix for him. God is not going to fix Nigeria, my dear. God is not going to fix that country. He is waiting on us to fix our country. He is waiting on us to raise up God-fearing men and women. He is waiting on us to raise up people who will have the pedigree, who will have what it takes to be able to put together everything that is needed to build a new nation in our land. I just don't think that our leaders, our even pastors, they meant evil. I think they've just taken it so far. But even God could not take the message of miracles so far. God is a miracle worker, but God knows when to do miracles, and God knows when to stop doing miracles. God knows when to stop doing miracles. God knows when to start doing miracles and when to stop. He started his miracles in a big way in Egypt when he wanted to set his people free. When he wanted to set his people free in Egypt, he did so many miracles that you cannot believe it. He did so much miracles that has not been recorded in the old Bible. He had so many miracles in Egypt. And then when he was in the wilderness when he was taking his people through the wilderness, he was doing even more greater miracles. I mean, God is a miracle working power, but God also knows when miracle is appropriate, and God knows where miracles are not appropriate. God knew that miracle was what was needed in Egypt, and he did a lot of them and brought his people out of captivity. When people of God that needed to be delivered, when God needs to deliver a nation, when God needs to deliver a country, when God needs to deliver a people, he begins to raise up men and women who will walk into supernatural, who will use the power of God, the rod of God, and the finger of God to set forth the people and to set them free from bondage and from captivity into liberty, into freedom. That is what God demonstrated for us and to us in the book of Exodus and the book of Genesis and with the story of the children of Israel in Egypt. And then in the wilderness, when they needed help, when there was no water, when there was no food, it was a desperate situation. God came forth with his mighty arm. He came forth with his mighty finger. He came forth to manifest himself in the wilderness, and he showed himself mighty. But God, this mighty God, this miracle working God, this all powerful God, this God that does miracle anytime he likes, this God that can do any form of miracle you want, imaginable and unimaginable miracles. When the children of Israel came out of Egypt And they went through the wilderness. As soon as they got away from the wilderness and they got and stepped in the promised land, God knew it was time to stop all those miracles. God knew when to do miracles and God knew when to stop miracles. And it was recorded in the book of Judges that as soon as the children of Israel enter into the promised land, when the last person entered to the promised land, the Bible records in chapter 5 of Joshua and then in chapter 12 of Judges that God sees the manna that was coming that from heaven to feed the children of Israel ceased coming down. All the big supernatural miracles that God was performing left and right, day and night, all of them ceased. He stopped all the miracles as soon as they got to the land. Now the same thing in Nigeria. That is why if God had continued doing miracles in the promised land, he would have incapacitated the children of Israel. Israel today would not have been one of the most developed countries in the world. If God had continued to do miracles in the land of Israel, the Israelis would not have been the smartest people in the world today. They would not want to have been the most savvy people in the world today. They would not have been the most developed people in the world today. They would not have been so emancipated that they have now. They would not have become so great as they have become now. Because they would have still kept on remaining and depending on God. But let me tell you something. There is really no difference between the wilderness and the promised land. The same wilderness, the promised land also was a dry place. It was also a wilderness. There is no oil flowing there. There is no raw materials there. There were no milk flowing there. There is no honey flowing there. They needed to know and discover by themselves how to cultivate their milk. They needed to know and develop technology, how to bring about the animals that will produce milk. They needed to raise up by their own ingenuity how to come up with their own honey in the wilderness. It was the same kind of wilderness where they could not supply for themselves as long as God was doing the miracles. You remember when they were 40 years in the wilderness, they didn't have development. They didn't have growth. They didn't have technology. They didn't have any supply of anything. They did not even have their own agriculture. They did not even have their own buildings, their own houses, their own technology, their own industry. They could not develop anything. Not because it was wilderness, but because God was giving everything to them ready-made. So God knew that if he needed to help these people, he must stop the miracles. He must downplay miracles. Now that is the cry that God is sending forth to the people of Africa. That is the message for Africa today. That is the message for Nigeria today. It is high time for us to begin to downplay miracles. It is high time for us to begin to talk less about miracles, about you being able to get something for nothing. It is high time that now we will begin to teach our people about the wisdom of God, about the ability to produce, about the ability to produce goods, about the wisdom to come about the process of production, to build industries, to build farms, to build services, to come up with ingenuity inventions, to come up with things that will astound the world and be able to bring us out of our poverty. It is now time for this church in Africa to begin to teach people how to walk with their hands, how to think with their mind, how to do the same thing that God made Israel to do in the wilderness. When they settled in the land of Israel, that was not because the land was fertile. The land was not fertile. The land was not great. It's still the same wilderness. But because there was nothing coming from heaven anymore, because God is no more bringing water from the rock anymore, he's no more sending meat from heaven anymore, He forced them into a situation where they will have to turn wilderness into that place where there is honey flowing. He forced them. He put them into a situation where they have to force themselves and they have to find the technology of making milk come out of farming products and come out of the land. They were put in that situation. And though the problem that I see with Nigeria and the problem that I see with Africa today is that we got used to the miracles. We got used to the supernatural messages. We got used to the focus on the supernatural. We got used to all the goodness of God that He performed among our people to bring them out of idolatry. Yes, our men of God performed miracles. Our men of God were anointed to do miracles. Those miracles were necessary to bring our continent out of the darkness that we were in. Those miracles were needed. They were anointed with miracles. People like Babalola, he needed to perform the miracles to break the chain and shackles of witchcraft and bondage that was holding down our people. But it is a misservice to God for the descendants of Babalola to still be carrying water, only water up and down. It is a disservice and a disgrace to God for the descendants of Babalola to still be praying for miracles from morning to night. It is a disgrace to the people who have already been delivered from bondage, who have already been delivered from witchcraft, to still be using the same method that Moses used. It would have been a disgrace for Joshua in the land of promise to begin to use the same method that Moses used in Egypt. It would have been a disgrace and a disservice to God for Joshua to still be teaching the children of Israel how to bring manna from heaven when they are already in a place of settlement. It would have been a disservice to God. Methods must change. Methods must change. It is time for the Nigerian people to know that the time for the method to change is now. We have been delivered from our Egypt. We have been brought through the wilderness of unbelief and idolatry. We have already come out of the wilderness. We have been 50 years out of our 40 years has expired. 50 years has expired as a nation. We have been delivered from unbelief. Now is a new time. It is now time that our pastors, our leaders, we begin to teach the next generation that no, it is no more time for us to begin to depend on God, to begin to ask Him for manna from above. It is no more time for us to begin to beg Him to send in water for us from the rock. It is no more time for those miracles. It is now high time for us to begin to use the mind of Christ that He has given to us. It is now high time that we do like the children of Israel, that we will begin to find technology to bring about honey in our home wilderness, that it is now time that we will begin to use the wisdom of God that is in us to bring honey and milk to in this land, for this land to flow with prosperity. It's not going to flow from heaven anymore. It's not going to flow from the rivers anymore. It's not going to flow from the stones and the mountains anymore. It's going to be flowing from our mind, from our ingenuity, from our creativity. But if we will continue to teach our people that God that delivered them in Egypt is still going to be using that same method, that is the only method that God uses, that is God that will do this and God will do that, if that is what we are going to keep on teaching people, we keep them in captivity. We keep them in ignorance. We keep them in perpetual bondage. We keep them in moral bondage. We keep them in spiritual bondage. We keep them in ignorance. We keep them in slavery, mental slavery. We don't do any good to them by keeping them dependent on miracles perpetually.
Hello, everybody. DSA here. I would like us to spread this word together. Let the gospel of the kingdom conquer the world. We only need you to help us take 5 simple steps. What are these steps? 1, go ahead and like the video, please, if you have not yet done that. Number 2, we need you to subscribe to this channel. Have you yet subscribed? Not yet done it? Go do it now. Number three, you need to press and click on that bell. You see the bell there? That will give you notification of every video that we do. Then the next thing you need to do, write your comments. Let's know what you think, good or bad. And then of course, you have other platforms like Instagram, like Facebook, share this video on your other platforms. All right? Let's win the world for Christ.